The next story is, I love this. It's where Obama is at a meeting, and a 9-year-old asks him, "Why do people hate you?" Well, he does what any great politician does. Says, first of all, they don't hate me. I won the election, you know, by 80 million votes, whatever. So it's not like people hate me. But the rest of the story is these people that you just described, the teabaggers that really are not, you know, they're not mom and pop. They're not, you know, these people are, if you follow each one of them, they tie into some right-wing nut group, whether it's the teabaggers, whether it's the John Birch Society, whether it's the KKK. I mean, they have them. Look, they even have teabaggers being interviewed that declare, yeah, I'm a white supremacist. I'm a KKK. This is what I do. So, I mean, it's not tough for a reporter to uncover. But anyway, Obama says, look, this is, you know, people don't really hate me. It is just the image that's been portrayed by the U.S. media because they don't have enough sense. They don't have enough brains to really look behind the story. It's like the balloon story. The kid, you know, CNBC jumps on the moon on the balloon story. Fox News, of course, all day long on the boy in the balloon story. Don't even ask the question: is there a boy in the balloon? And that's the problem. We don't really have media, news media anymore.
Well, we got a couple of other good media stories. One is just an interesting story. My old friend Neil Cavuto is actually one of the more decent people on Fox News.
Yeah, I like Neil. I appear on the show a lot.
Right, and he's fair when you're on the show. He doesn't interrupt as much as the other guys, and he's kind of a decent character. He has some kind of intellectual integrity, but he's the best of the group. But what he has now, what he said this week was that he began calling the recovery that we're now going through of the stock market anyway, not of the broader economy, but he calls it the Bush recovery and is urging everybody to call it the Bush recovery. He says, well, you know, they were blaming the recession on Bush, so so the recovery must also be Bush's.
Well, what do you do if you're Neil? I mean, look, like I say, you know, Neil's a decent guy. I mean, but he's surrounded by these, you know, by this message that has to get out there. So that's the kind of thing he delivers.
Yeah, here's a sign of hope, Mike, that the Argentine Senate has overwhelmingly approved a media law to break up the media monopolies. They had the same thing in Argentina as they had in Nazi Germany during the Hitler's chancellorship, and as we've had in this country since after Reagan destroyed the Fairness Doctrine, abolished the Fairness Doctrine, which is five media companies took over all of the radio and television stations in the country. The entire publicly owned airwave spectrum was controlled by five giant multinational corporations, and most of them were this media oligopoly, right-wing, controlled by the big corporations. And the Argentine government said, enough is enough. We're returning them to the people. They passed a law that says 2/3 of the radio and TV spectrum must be reserved for non-commercial stations and stations that require local content to build local communities and to reinforce local democracy, rather than being controlled by giant corporations in order to sell products and enrich themselves.
One thing you can count on, that will never happen here. Because you know why? The media now works, basically, they are exactly on the same marching orders that the U.S. Chamber of Commerce has given them. And I love this next story. I love the story that the big U.S. Chamber of hoax, where they're telling the American public, and they're telling the media, and they're telling lawmakers that they have 3 million people in their 3 million organizations are behind the U.S. Chamber of Commerce.
Well, I saw them. I saw the head of the chamber go on television this week on one of the Sunday morning talk shows, and say he was accused he said, people have been accusing the chamber of just representing Wall Street interests rather than representing small business people. And the guy said, no, 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 no. Let me tell you something about the chamber. We represent 3 million businesses around the country. Only a few of those, a thousand of those are Wall Street businesses. The vast majority of our membership come from these other 3 million businesses. Well, later, they were forced this week to admit, because Mother Jones did an expose of that number, and they just pulled that number out of the air. And in fact, their number is about one-tenth of that, fewer than 300,000. In fact, in 2002, even their own propaganda was saying that they had 150,000 members.
Yeah. Well, here's the real problem. The Chamber of Commerce no longer represents mom-and-pop organizations, but mom-and-pop businesses through their local chamber still keep sending the U.S. Chamber money. Now, here's the problem the U.S. Chamber has. They've been able to operate below the radar screen. They've been able to secretly do things like destroy the Buy American slogan, you know, where they paid Wall Street to go in and say, don't buy an American. Where they sent money to legislators to say defeat Buy American in our stimulus packages. They've done all that. Now the latest thing is their work against climate change, where they're out there and they're saying, you know, there is such thing as climate change, but cold weather's actually good for us. I mean, this is the talking. But
right. So people, and they spent a record $34.7 million on federal lobbying in the third quarter of this year. It's a world record. And virtually all of that money went to lobby for the big pharmaceutical industry, the big insurance companies from Wall Street, and the big carbon cronies, you know, who are lobbying, and Nuke, were lobbying for against the climate change bill.
If you are a small business owner and you're listening to this program, you heard it here first. Do not send another dime to the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, because you know what? That's what's happening around the country now. People have stopped sending their money to the U.S. Chamber of Commerce because they understand the U.S. Chamber of Commerce doesn't represent them. They represent Exxon, Merck, Halliburton, all the mega corporations. They don't have anything in common with mom and pop.
Well, it's the same thing as the American Farm Bureau. If you're a farmer, you're absolutely nuts in this country. If you're a family farmer, to support the American Farm Bureau, because their agenda, they're an insurance company, not a farm organization. Their policies are dictated by Monsanto and by corporate agriculture, by Tyson, by Cargill, by Premium Standard Farms, by Purdue.
Let's pick up with that. We got to take a break. I'm getting the signal.
Smithfield Foods.
Take a break. We're going to be right back. Bobby Kennedy and myself, we're talking about the news behind the news. We're going to be right back.